Captain Blush, eh? Yes. For once, eh, you can just fill me in the plane.
Again with the time.
Because Captain Blush was such a cool time, eh? What can I zoom on here, eh? But hey, hey. Concentrate on me because eh, the wind is picking up again. Eh? This will be something, eh? I can't believe this, eh?
If it is destined to be ruined, then it will be ruined.
But eh, I can't believe, eh?
How is this possible? Look how it is blowing. Look at this. Look at this. Look at this.
Now we have just done the great maiden flight with the Sky Sword on 6 setup A, and that was perfect. Of course, I have seen how the wind was tossing the plane, but hey, screw that, eh? And now the famous question, I will just start. I don't think that I have saluted anybody. First, I will salute all subscribers and viewers. Thanks for your support, for visiting our channel, for all your comments, for your subscriptions, and for being our friends, of course, eh? And for sharing and spreading the passion for the RC planes from this channel to the rest of the world, eh? Because we all know by now that flying RC planes, that can be the peak of your life, eh? And I can't imagine better hobby. So if you're still wondering to click something, eh? But click something already and fly the damn plane already. And believe me, eh? You won't stop at just one plane, eh?
So, just don't click Blitzworks.
Well, I must explain something today, hey, Captain Blush. I will explain something because, of course, the famous question, what do we have today? Our famous SR-71 Blackbird in all its glory again here. Now you have seen the maiden flight with this because that was nothing, eh? I have crashed the plane. I was really struggling to keep the plane alive for as long as I could, eh? And I really thought that I will land that. But something just happened with the one motor and the plane was out of the control and that's it. Now, of course, we have tested in our workshop. One thing that we have discovered is that this baby really needs a high C rating that they don't recommend, but hey, we always test the plane with recommended batteries so we can see what will happen. But screw that. The point is that I must explain something. Now, there were many comments under the crash video about banana hobby store and I don't know what. I must explain right now and right here, eh? I don't know nothing about the banana hobby store because I have never ordered nothing from them, eh? I have ordered this plane in Europe in some warehouse in France, I think, in one store, hey. Because they are saying that the banana hobby is not good store and I don't know what. I mean, I don't know because I don't have the experience with that store. Now, I did wanted originally to order this plane from that store, I don't know, maybe 2 years ago. But the shipping was over $160 and I said, hey, for that money, if I never fly this plane in my life. But like I said, I have found it in the France. So, hey, it has nothing to do with how the banana store sells things. I don't know. So if you have bad experience, hey, I don't know. And the other thing is Pete. The pilot Pete who is doing the reviews for the banana hobby. I mean, hey, I was watching many of his videos. I have never mentioned him before in the videos of this plane. Because I will salute right now pilot Pete, hey. Because he, for me, he is the professional pilot and he's really good pilot. Now, of course, if he is doing for a living reviews for some company, it's hard to expect that he will say some bad thing about that plane. That's obvious, eh? But I respect his flying and he has nothing to do with this plane. I mean, he was flying this plane good on that review. I mean, I still don't know with what he was flying, but for me, this plane just wasn't working on the maiden flight and that's it, eh? And we will stop at that, good enough, eh? And now what I have done, we have tested this in our workshop. We have seen that even with the higher C rating battery, something was going on with one EDF. They were working perfect and then just one started to get big rotations and one was dying and I don't want to risk the plane with those motors anymore. So what I will do today, I mean, hey, I really wished for no wind, but hey, hey. Because now, viewers, I will tell you this, hey, you will wonder from the beginning to the end because I will show you something with what I will fly this plane today. Now look at this, hey. Show this. Because I know right now they're saying, hey, but he is crazy, eh? If he wasn't able to fly this plane on 4-cell, how the hell will he fly this on 3-cell batteries, eh? Captain Blush!
I will not
You're
say...
also wondering, eh?
No, I know why. I will not say anything until the end.
Because viewers, I don't care anymore. I have fixed the plane and I will try to fly it. Now let's hope that it will fly with this. Now I don't have much flying time. 2 minutes and 10 seconds. After that, I will have to start to land.
Maybe even less.
Maybe even less. Yeah. Well, let's hope not, Abe, this time, Abe. But later, of course, I will show you if the flight will be good or if it will not be good, okay? I will show you what I have done on this plane. And I will show you something, because all the viewers were wondering that on the first flight, the CG was not okay. I will show you now the CG, hey. Because the recommended CG, and even on this CG, I will show you something, hey. It's exactly here, hey. Look at this. Don't tell me that it was the tail heavy. Look at this, hey. The plane is pretty nose heavy on the recommended CG. Now the plane was flying. Now I must explain, why was the plane flying like this on the maiden flight? Because I was pulling all up elevator that I had all the time to keep the plane in the air. There was no way to level it because the plane would just crash immediately if I had done that. So hey, yes. Hey. And that is why, I mean,
you have to understand that viewers were not here.
Yeah.
They don't know everything.
Well, of course they don't know, and I didn't show you that in fact, with this battery, you still have the nose heavy plane like it should be, hey, I think. Hey. So this is it.
Yes.
Now this will be something, hey.
Yes, good luck.
Hey, I really want to see this plane fly good, at least for once, because right now...
Wind is stopping, I think.
Because right now I know that the viewers are wondering about... A free cell, that is just crazy. Are you ready for something, eh?
I think this will be the first free cell SR-71 on the planet.
I think so too, eh? Now let's hope that it will work, something, eh? Are you ready, Captain Blush,
yes,
for something here, eh?
This is a bit different than the first time.
And now just film it good because, hey, we don't have much time, to screw here.
Wind is very, very strong. It's tossing the plane all over the place.
But now it doesn't all just climb, huh? What do you think, Captain Blush, eh?
You are an EDF, I don't know what, master, guru, or...
Look at this in all its glory, look at this, eh? Hey!
Well, the sound sounds familiar to me.
It's strong wind, but hey.
It's in the air.
Not bad, huh?
No.
1 minute, we don't have much time today. Yes, I will suck quickly this battery.
Would you prepare for the landing?
Would you tell that it doesn't look pretty good, eh?
Yes.
Now, of course, I will prepare for the landing. I will just come once more. I will put out the landing gear.
30 seconds.
Do it now.
Look what the wind is doing, okay?
Now prepare.
Prepare for the landing?
Yes.
I really couldn't control it because of the wind, hey.
No, the wind was strong, but...
The wind was really too strong, but hey.
You can fix this elevator.
It survived, hey.
You can fix this wing for the third time.
Well, this was already broken in the box, eh? But hey, everything else survived. Look at this, eh?
Yeah, of course it survived.
And this, and even this one, because this one was broken all the way on the on the maiden flight, eh?
This is the least of your worries now.
But hey, I'm... Hey, now, again, I will have to fly this again, Captain Blush. Eh? Because this landing was nothing, eh?
And I will, I will tell you, I told you, you know why?
Why?
We were just talking 5 minutes ago before the flight. Why don't you look? There is a 1 mile long runway, and you have
but
to.
But Captain Blush, don't blame me. I'm only only human, eh? So don't put the blame on me.
Okay,
eh?
I know you were nervous.
I was doing my best. Eh?
Yeah, you're nervous. I can understand you.
Can you imagine how nervous I was today, eh? To prove something here, and I did prove something to the viewers that you can fly this plane. And I was flying in a free cell. Now, of course, I will take it out.
And now you must explain the because there is something missing here.
Of course, I have popped out that because that was nothing. I mean, I have tried to glue one in, but it was just crooked all the way. So I said, what the hell, eh? This is actually obstructing the air to come through the plane. It doesn't look so scaly it was, but who cares about the scale, eh? As long as I was flying it. Now, hey, I do have a little bitter taste now because of this landing.
Yeah,
this
you
was
did,
nothing again.
Who cares about
but
the landing?
Yours,
the flight still, was okay.
Hey, the wind is really strong, hey, and I didn't want to fly it in such a strong wind. But who cares at the end, hey? I have proven to you that you can fly this plane, and that's it, hey. Now, what's this, hey? Now, I will close the landing gears while I have still plug it in. I will just have to...
It's good enough.
Well, it is just banded like it was on the first flight. Let's just check quickly if everything is still working. Oh yeah, viewers, there will be the second flight. The EDFs, of course, and we will check how much I have sucked exactly after...
Not you, but the EDFs.
I mean, the EDFs have sucked after 3 minutes of flying, and I will show you because, hey, the viewers are still wondering in how the hell were you able to fly with the graphene-free cell battery? I will show you quick, and then I will tell you what I have done. Look at this. Oh, 50%.
That's it.
That's it, eh?
If you wouldn't land this time,
if
that
I
would be...
If I wouldn't land in my car, hey! I think that it will be total crash again, because if I made one more turn, that would be the end of story. So maybe in half, maybe at the end, with this crashing, I have saved the plane. Now, of course, this wing, hey, but screw that, eh? I was flying this plane, and that's it. I will put it like this. Of course, now I will fix it, and I think that I will just fix it, and I will just hang it in my hangar, and that's it, eh? I was flying it, and that was good enough for me, and now I will tell you what I have done. Now, like we said, we were testing the EDFs that were installed on 4-cell batteries. The ESCs were getting hot from those EDFs, and there was just something wrong, because, hey... It didn't matter what battery I was testing them on. One EDF got the speed and one was dying, and it doesn't matter what. And if I have left those EDFs in, I have ordered 2265C batteries, but I will use them on some other planes, because I know right now that even with those batteries, I would crash the plane because it would be out of control like it was on the maiden flight. So what I have done, I have set on the thrust to ratio, to weight ratio video, that I was in my hangar watching one bird, eh? And I got great idea. And that bird was, do you know what it was?
Yeah, I know.
The Neptune, the Tech 1 Neptune flying wing, the EDF 1, eh? I was remembering how much thrust that plane has on that 5-bladed 64mm EDF, and the bird is flying on 3-cell batteries. So I have went quickly to the Motion RC, and there were exactly 2 EDF units left on stock. So I have bought them both. They cost me, I think, 27 euros each one, and I have changed them. That is why you can see here that they were changed. I have put it here the how do you call it?
Silicone.
I have put it here the silicone to cover all the holes here, and you can see, you can check in the back, look at this, eh? Do you see them? They are still 5-bladed, eh?
Yes.
And I have also put out those cones in the back that I had inside, because at the end, I'm still wondering about the EDF jets, viewers. I still have many questions, eh? Now, if you look at this Hobbikin Skysword, he has reduced out exhaust.
Outlet.
Yeah. But to tell you the truth, I really don't understand that. But what's with that? Because even if you reduce the cone on the exhaust, you will have the bigger speed of the air coming out from the plane, but the amount of air will still be the same. It doesn't matter what you have in the back. So I really don't know anymore, hey. But hey.
You have done it.
It must be something like this, and I have done a good job. And if, I don't know who is the manufacturer of this, it's not Blitzwerk. I think that it's Langxiang or something, the company.
Who?
Langxiang or...
What's this, eh?
Yeah, that is the company that produces this place.
This sounds like some kind of disease.
well, screw that, it doesn't matter. Now, if they have put it in the EDFs like I did, you would have many more happy pilots in the world. Because those were nothing. Or at least put good EDF units in, eh?
Maybe you got defected one.
Yeah. Well, I don't know, but the final truth is, you can't sell... I mean, hey, I still love this plane. Even now that I have broken it again, I was flying. That is a perfect feeling. Hey. And I will glue it back together, and I will be very happy to just watch it in my hangar. And I'm happy that I had one, but $300 for this, hey, that is just not good, and that's the end of story. You can sell this plane for, I don't know, maybe
$150,
and it should work good, and then it would be worth $150, but not $300 for this, because, hey, at the end...
They're selling deluxe.
For that kind of money, you can buy all sorts of other things that will fly good, and you will not have the broken plane every time that you will go flying. But hey, screw that. That is why we are having this channel, to test the planes for you and to have the perfect fun, because at the end, hey, even if I have crashed this plane again, who cares, hey? I don't care, I really don't care. Because hey, it was crashed before, but the point is that I was flying, and that compensates for all, eh? Because I will never forget when I was flying the SR-71 Blackbird, eh? And I was flying it good in such strong wind that sick, eh? So this is it, yes, enough of this.
Yes, enough.
That's the end of story of this plane. But I think, Captain Blush, that maybe I will take that F-117 again, eh? And I will glue it back, because we have also broken that one on the maiden flight a little, yeah, on the rudder, say.
Uh-huh.
I will glue that back, and maybe we will test that plane here, because here...
You know what?
That would take off, eh?
You have made me aroused with that Tech 1 Neptune. I think I will have to fly it, eh?
Well, Captain Blush, I will give it to you, eh?
No, I will fly it.
I will give it to you, that plane.
Yeah, I know why. Because you need some space again.
No, I will give you because we want to see at least one in 2 years of filming, Captain Blush, almost three. We didn't see Captain Blush to fly an EDF jet, eh, by now.
I didn't?
Yeah, I don't think that we have a video of you flying EDF jet, eh?
There is one on my channel that lasts 9 seconds.
Yeah.
Twister, multiplex.
This is pretty much like in your bedroom, eh?
Yeah, speak
maybe
for yourself.
A few seconds more, eh?
Hey, don't judge others by yourself,
of
eh?
Of course, viewers, we are just kidding here. Yeah, yeah. And that's it, eh? We love you all, of course. Thanks for stopping by. This was the Sunday morning flying. We know that tomorrow we will have rain. We have, for the last 3 days, the wind was really so strong that we couldn't film nothing. So we have filmed this even here today in this wind. I was risking the planes, but hey, you can't just choose the weather, eh? And since this is not the weather channel, hey, screw all, eh? So this is it.
Yes.
Expect more. Of course, Captain Blush has prepared his planes. We thought that he will fly at his pits today, but he doesn't have time. So that will be the next one on the menu.
I got two planes. One is gasoline, one is nitro. One will be fast as F, and one will be slow and...
Hey, that will be something, viewers, and just wait, eh, for the good weather, and then it will be all Captain Blush's time all over again.
All hell will break loose.
Thanks. Captain Blush, we will go for Sunday morning coffee, of course, eh, like we always do, with beautiful, sexy...
waitresses.
Cream from the cows, not just cream from plants, because for... I still don't understand.
Hey, didn't you said already goodbye?
With the cream from plants. Now what's that?
They're milking the plants, yes.
Yeah, which plant you can suck the milk off?